Welcome to this presentation of the Master of Public Policy program at the Willy Brandt School of Public Policy. I'm course coordinator at Brandt School. My name is Christian Tischmeier. In this presentation, I will provide you with an overview of the curriculum, which is structured into so-called modules, and I will tell you how to register for your courses. All of this should take roughly 12 minutes. Here you see an overview of some important dates during the winter semester 2020-21. As you see, while the semester is formally already ongoing since October the 1st, lectures will only start on November the 2nd. They will go on until February 20th next year. However, exams may still take place afterwards, typically until the end of February. Exact dates of these exams will be announced by the lecturer, typically in the first session of the lecture or seminar. In winter term, there will be a Christmas break until after New Year's Day. In that time, not only will no lectures and seminars take place, but also Brandt School and university offices will be closed, and most services at the university will not be available. Here you see an overview of the whole curriculum, already grouped into modules, visualized in black. From left to right, you see the progression of your four semesters, which will structure your 2 years of study at Brandt School. The big block to the right is your master's thesis. We will now briefly go into all the modules before finishing off by introducing course registration. As we will go through the modules and courses, you will see that they are assigned different numbers of so-called credit points. Each credit point stands for a workload of roughly 30 hours per semester. There are 3 and 6 credit point courses. All modules on top of the courses include one module examination for 3 credits. Credit points are awarded upon successful completion of a course. Grades are given for the whole module based on the one examination. For your final average grade, grades are weighted by credit points. That means that grades of 9 credit point modules count relatively more to your final average as compared to 6 credit point modules. For graduation, you need 120 credit points. That means in 4 semesters, that on average you will need to earn 30 credit point per semester. That breaks down to 6 or 7 courses per semester. There is a difference between courses and modules. You will need to finish a total of 13 modules within the Master of Public Policy. Typically, one module consists of 1 course and 1 exam. However, a few modules have 2 courses per module, so that you end up taking 15 or 16 courses altogether. You are free to do more courses, but will then need to decide which shall be named in your final transcript at the end of your studies. On this sheet, you have an overview of the modules, but let's take a closer look one section at a time. There are 3 modules in the policy analysis part of the Master of Public Policy program. Each of these modules, Introduction to Public Policy, Economic Analysis and Modeling, as well as Comparative and International Public Policy, include 1 lecture and 1 examination. The Introduction to Public Policy also includes a tutorial, which will mainly serve as an advanced academic writing course. Altogether, you will earn 21 credit points in this module. The Public Administration and Management part of your program will include 3 modules, Public Administration and Finance, Management and Leadership, as well as Ethics in the Public Sector. All of this again come as 1 lecture and 1 exam. In this module, you will altogether earn 18 credit points. Also, you will have 2 methods modules. That is, for 1, the quantitative methods lecture and exam in your 2nd semester. In your 3rd semester, also meant as a preparation for your master's thesis, you will have an advanced methods class. Together, you will earn 12 credit points here. As a practice-oriented program, the 2 practical training modules take center stage in the Master of Public Policy. 1 module will entail your internship. The internship counts for 6 credit points, which, when you multiply it by 30 hours per credit point, means 180 hours of workload. That workload includes the internship report, which you will need to submit so that your internship gets accredited. The internship shall typically take place in the semester break between your 2nd and 3rd semester, so for you in August and September 2021. You may decide to go for a longer internship or one at a different point of time. However, that requires extra planning. There will be an extra session on your internship next week, hosted by Florian Heinze as your internship coordinator. The other practical training module will include a project group. That is an intense seminar where you will engage in political consulting for an external project partner. This might be an NGO, a think tank, or a public office. This project group will take place in your third term, so in winter 2021-22. While so far we have dealt with compulsory modules, you only need to complete two of the four specialization modules. The four specializations are called Nonprofit Management and Social Entrepreneurship, International and Global Public Policy, Development and Socioeconomic Policies, and Conflict Studies and Management. In each of the two specializations you will be taking, you will do two seminars and one module examination. That examination, which may be a paper or an oral exam or a combination of the both, will be connected to one of the two seminars you are taking. We will have an extra session on the specializations next Monday, as the relevant professors or some of the academic staff will briefly introduce each of the specializations. We will do this as a WebEx session, so more on this later. In the language module, you are required to progress one level in one language. So you will do one or two courses worth 6 credit points in one language. Should you have not German skills equivalent to at least level A2, that language will need to be German. The module examination will be included in the language courses, and your performance in this will decide on your grade in the language module. The final module, completing your Master of Public Policy, includes your master thesis and a colloquium. This is planned for your fourth and final term, and typically all of your academic efforts in that term will go into the master thesis. It is worth 30 credit points, one quarter of your total program workload. While this sounds like it massively influences your grade, in fact, it does not so much. Even performing a whole grade better or worse than in your average of your courses, you will improve or decrease your final average only by 0.1 of a grade. Nonetheless, it will be a lot of work that requires timely preparation. We will talk about this in a good year from now, when you should already think about your thesis topic. As an illustration, this may be a possible course selection during your first term. Besides the mandatory classes, this student is taking the German course offered by Brand School. Also, the student is taking two specialization courses, one in the Nonprofit and Social Entrepreneurship specialization and one in the International Global Public Policy. Altogether, these are 7 courses. Remember, Introduction to Public Policy has 2 courses, and 30 credit points in total. As a second example, this is another course selection that a student might take. On top of the very same compulsory courses, this student is taking a different language class, Basic Russian. This class, in fact, has 2 parts, literal and oral skills. They need to be taken in combination, though, and will be taught by the same lecturer. Reflecting the bigger workload of the class, it is rewarded with 6 credit points. This selection is completed by one specialization course in development and socioeconomic policies. Depending on whether you count the language class as 1 or 2, this again makes 6 or 7 courses and 30 credit points in total. So, how do you register for your courses? You will get the chance in the 3rd and 4th week of the lecture period, so mid to end November this term. These first 4 weeks are what we call the shopping period. You can visit the courses that interest you and decide whether you want to take them for credit or not. During course registration period, you can then formally register for all the courses that you like to complete that term. Make sure that you also register for your compulsory classes and the attendant module examinations. By sending your course registration sheet to Public Policy in time, you can make sure that we will also double-check your course registration so that you are not forgetting anything. Before doing that, please clarify with your academic mentor that they are okay with your course choice. They should have a look on your choice of specialization courses and an appropriate workload. These are screenshots from and the link to the online course catalog, ALVIS. To the left, you see the submenu of the Master of Public Policy modules and all the courses offered within one specialization in blue. From the very same platform, you can also get a certificate of enrollment as well as an overview of your grades as soon as they are registered. In order to get an official transcript of records, so a certified overview of your grades with a stamp, you will need to contact the department Studium und Lehre. the grades of your examinations will be given in this format, ranging from 1.0 as outstanding to 4.0 as mere pass. Grades are given in the steps 0.0, 0.3, 0.7, but through combined grades you might actually end up with module grades like 1.79 or 2.07. A fail, for example not handing in a term paper on time, is marked as 5.0. Each of your courses will also have an online room on the e-learning platform Moodle. With your student account's username and password, you can also log in there. You will either be automatically registered with your courses in case of compulsory classes like public administration and finance, for example, or you can register yourself, typically using a preset password. These passwords will be given to you in due time before or during start of lectures. So, ALVIS and Moodle are two distinct systems, which at the University of Erfurt serve different purposes. While on ALVIS, you can get your enrollment certificate, register for your courses during course registration period, and see the list of courses you have already completed and the grades you got, on Moodle, you get readings and other course materials, have a forum for announcement by the lecturers and for discussions within the course, and may submit your coursework like term papers if lecturers use this platform as such. Thank you very much for listening through the presentation. In case of questions, please just contact me either via email or telephone. You find both of my contacts here. Take care and goodbye.